Now we'll see the different configuration of TDD frames or subframes. As per the 3GPP standards, we have 7 different frame configuration in TDD or the frame type 2. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 7 different frame configuration in TDD. We already discussed what is a subframe. It's nothing but downlink pilot time slot and uplink power time slot, and the guard period. Guard period consists of 2 propagation times and 1 switching period. So that we have already discussed in the previous session. So now we'll be discussing on the different kind of frame configuration used in TDD. Frame type 0. So we have 10 subframe here, as you can see. So we can use it as half frame or full frame. So I have taken the full frame example. So the first subframe of every TDD frame type 2 is a downlink subframe, for sure. Everything starts with a downlink subframe. Then the second one is reserved for special subframes, and the third one is reserved for uplink. So those three are constant, whatever the frame configuration may be, or irrespective of any frame configuration. First subframe is a downlink subframe, the second subframe is a special subframe, and the third one is reserved for uplink. That is why I have colored them red, red and blue for downlink. Then the differentiation starts. Like for frame type 0, we have 6 uplink subframes, 2 downlink subframes and 2 special subframes, because we are switching from downlink to uplink 2 times here. I hope it's clear for you. So this we can use as a half frame, because this half frame is just copied in the second half of the frame. Downlink, special subframe, uplink, 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 and then downlink, special subframe, uplink, uplink and uplink. So this is frame configuration type 0, wherein we have maximum uplink frames reserved and minimum downlink, only 2 downlink subframes and 2 special subframes as usual is required, because we are switching from downlink to uplink. From uplink to downlink, we don't need any kind of special subframes. From uplink to downlink, wherever you see, no special subframe required. Only from downlink to uplink we need a special subframe, because the UE needs to be retuned from receiver to transmitter mode. So when in downlink, the receiver is in receiving mode, and when it wants to start some transmission, it needs a guard period or some switching time to, you know, from receiver to change itself to a transmitter. So that switching period is required. That's why we are using a special subframe wherever we have a change from downlink to uplink. From uplink to downlink, we don't need any subframe. Directly from uplink transmission to downlink can happen. We'll go to the frame configuration type 2, which is consist of 2 downlink, 2 uplink and 1 special subframe. So 2 downlink and 2 uplink and 1 special subframe in a half frame. And if you'll see the second part also, 2 downlink, 2 uplink and 1 special subframe. So in half frame and full frame it is the same. We are using 2 uplink, 2 downlink and 1 special subframe. We'll go to frame configuration type 3, or here 0, 1 and 2. So here we are having 3 downlink and 1 uplink and 1 special subframe. That means here we are giving maximum capacity in the downlink from the bandwidth we are having in a half frame. I'm talking about the half frame now. So 3 downlink, 1 uplink and 1 special subframe. So in this half frame, we can see this is the best configuration for maximum bandwidth allocation in a downlink site. In the second half of the frame, it is the same downlink, 1 special, 1 uplink and 2 downlink. So in total, if you see, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 downlink subframes, 2 uplink subframes, 2 special subframe. Total is 10. 6 versus 2 versus 2. 2 special during switching, 6 downlink and 2 uplink, 2 special subframes. We'll go to subframe type 4 or 0123. Don't be confused with my numbers and type. This is type 1, but I have started the numbering from 0. So 0 is type 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but total is 7. So type 4 is 3 uplink in a half frame, 1 downlink and 1 special subframe. In the second half, all are downlink. So it is a full frame. So we can differentiate here. These 3 can be used as full or half frame. Because the configuration in both the halves or the subframes, this side is the same. You can check. Downlink, special and uplink is common. Uplink, uplink, downlink, uplink, 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 downlink, uplink, downlink, and downlink. So this is, I think, yeah, this is the same. But from type 4 till type 6, these are only the scheduler can change the transmission only in one full frame. Half frame configuration is not possible for this frames. So we'll go type 4, wherein we are having 2 uplink subframes, 1 special subframe, sorry, 3 uplink subframe, 1 special subframe and 6 downlink subframe. In type 4, we are having only 2 uplink subframe, 7 downlink subframe, 3, 3, 6, 1, 7 and 1 special subframe. In type 5, which is very popular in terms of downlink throughput, we are having maximum downlink subframes. We are having 8 downlink subframe, 1 uplink subframe and 1 special subframe. So this is frame type 5. This is the secret behind the maximum throughput of many of the operators. So when we use subframe type 5, we can have maximum throughput because in downlink we are allocating maximum bandwidth. 8 subframes for the downlink, 1 subframe for the uplink and 1 special subframe. So remember this technique to get the maximum throughput in the downlink. And the last but not the least is we are having 5 uplink subframes, 3 downlink subframe and 2 special subframes. So 5 is 2, 3 is 2, 2. Downlink, downlink and downlink, 3 downlink, 2 special subframes and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 uplink subframes. So those are all different kind of frame configuration in TDD or in frame type 2. I hope you really enjoying the sessions starting from the beginning, and stay tuned for more updates in physical layer, channels and the procedures. We'll be coming up with some more topics tomorrow, and this is the end of the session. Do comment us if you really like the videos, do share the videos if you want to share it with somebody, and do subscribe if you have not subscribed yet, and click on that bell button to get the further notifications on our upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.